All right. The president has been talking up a lot of things these days to try to get the two sides together. But no sooner had they gotten together than at least a concern expressed for not enough strategic investing. You're going to hear some of that from what the president has collectively been saying this week about more strategic investing. Conservatives read that as more spending that could compound the problem. I'm here right now with Congressman Steve King, Republican Iowa, what he makes of that. Strategic investing is spending, right?
Well, clearly it is spending, and there's been some discussion about this going up to this point over the last 2 or 3 months. The president has tried to find a way to put another economic stimulus plan together, and he's made 2 or 3 runs at this. One of them was a couple of months ago when he said we need to spend more money and invest it in education, some into infrastructure. And when I heard the education remark, and we're in a short-term economic situation that we need to have confidence in investors, we need jobs that are stimulated. And when you invest it in education, that is a good investment for the long run, but it doesn't fix our problem today.
All right, but I think what he's trying to say is in the middle of this, we can't lose sight of the type of things that longer term will make us better. But I do see your point. When you're broke, you're broke. You don't have those options. But I think that's kind of the clear sum up of where you guys stand, right? He is still inclined to want to spend more. You guys are still inclined to want to cut more. And here we go.
Oh, there's going to be, I have a picture of two bulls knocking their heads together on my office wall, Neil. And so that tells you what's going on from that. But I think this, that the American people were ready for real cuts. And when you see 87 freshman Republican come into this Congress, they wanted to repeal and defund Obamacare. They wanted to cut off funding to Planned Parenthood.
Do you think you guys are overreaching the Congress in that, in this particular measure, on this particular budget that, as you and I know, wasn't a budget, it was a continuing something from last year the Democrats should have taken care of, that you were piling on, that you were throwing things in there that just distracted from your theme, and that you overplayed your hand?
Not at all. I think we should have played our hand harder. I think we should have looked at this first term of the 112th Congress this way, and that is that we needed to look at the leverage points. This CR was the highest leverage point that we have for the next 2 years. The next leverage point is the debt ceiling. Beyond that, then there's not another leverage point until Harry Reid sends our appropriations
so
bills
you were
back
making,
and on
that was
spending.
A big point. You're happy with that? You'll vote for this?
No.
Really?
I will vote no, and I'll vote no because...
Well, how many will vote no with you?
Looks like 28 last night was the number. Whether that number gets larger or smaller, I don't know. But I voted no because...
Do you think this thing could fall apart in the next few days?
I don't expect that it will. I haven't had enough discussion to know yet, Neil, whether it will or whether it won't. But I'm of this opinion that the maximum leverage point was this, shut off all funding to Obamacare. We've got $23.6 billion automatically appropriated to implement that. And the bitter irony is if we had faced it and had a government shutdown, the lights would have gone off all over this city, but Obamacare would have been implemented anyway, even when the troops might not have been paid.
Wow. That's Congressman, I know you want to race back to your fine state. Thank you very,
Thanks,
very
Neil.
Much. Good seeing you.
I appreciate
all right.
it.